An absolutely critical subject is resilient leadership. And guess what? It may not be what you think. You might think it's being tough. It's about taking the knocks and getting yourself off and dusting yourself off and just getting on with it and being this tough, tough guy. Wrong. That is going to break you. We are living in this crazy times, as I've said before. You know, it's like the biggest spanner in the works. And it's accelerated life on Earth in terms of what's important and what's not important. And resilient leadership is important, but it's not what you think. It's not this tough guy, alpha male thing. In fact, alpha males have caused a lot of damage and are out of date. And the metrics have been wrong because no one's measured the damage that was done in terms of high staff attrition, wrong decision-making, too much ego in the room. All of that kind of stuff has caused massive issues worldwide. So resilient leadership is way more fluid, dynamic. It's not the big rock that's immovable. It's the water that flows around the rock. You need to be the water. You need to be fluid, dynamic, flexible. No, water is way more powerful than granite. And resilient leadership requires a key word that might blow you away, and that is vulnerability. Yes, vulnerability. The ability to say, I don't know. The ability to say, hey, I'm not quite sure what to do here, team, and I need you. The ability to say, wow, I'm struggling. I'm really struggling with this. I'm hitting brick walls. I'm not getting through. The ability to connect to your heart. The ability to cause deep human connection through authenticity. Resilience is creating psychological safety, which requires trust. And trust requires that authenticity that I've already spoken to. It requires the ability to have space for another, the ability to appreciate diversity. Authenticity, by the way, is not also what you might think it is. It's not speaking my mind all the time, offering my opinions, not volunteered, just offering my opinions. That's not authenticity. Authenticity is bringing your deepest values through. For example, it could be kindness or compassion, or the need for human connection. It's bringing those through, authoring those things through in the right space and time for a better human connection, better team ethos, better culture, better way of doing things. So to become anti-fragile, we need to become more fragile. That means more the ability to bend and be more fluid, as I mentioned. So that's what resilience is, because if you can do that, if you can have profound, deep conversations, then people are able to get up again. They're able to move. They're able to have the energy to learn, to grow, to expand. That's what resilience is. It is not this unbending, tough thing that doesn't move and in the end cracks and falls apart at the seams. Let's talk about this on a deeper level. Let's have a far greater understanding of what it is to be human in these times and how to do this virtually, because it can be done. It absolutely can be done. It needs a high level of presence, thought, and consideration. And you can have a resilient team. You yourself can be more resilient. And you can outlast competitors who are still lost in the old paradigm. So let's have a conversation about this. Let's see what needs to be done to cause a greater level of resilience, because it is so necessary. There's more curveballs that are on the way. So let's be like a ninja in language and resilience, fluid, able to move, able to connect, able to put the right context in place for the great seeds of potential to grow, rather than just banging our head again and again on a wall, which is the height of insanity. So, ready to have that conversation? I know we are, because you can see I'm quite passionate about this. Let's do it. Thank you.